Hello guys, welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss how to assume the depth of a beam. Through this class I will show you how to assume the depth of many kind of beams. So let's begin. I first give a heading. Assuming the depth of beam. So in load cases, many load cases, the beam can divide into three categories. First one is light beam. That's mean the loads are not heavy, not medium, just light. Second one is medium, greater than the light beam, and the third one is heavy beam. Now the span ranges of this beam will be span ranges will be for light beam is 3 to 4 meters, for medium beam it will be 5 to 10 meters, for heavy beam it will be 10 meters, or you know, greater than 10 meters, sorry, it will be 5. Okay. Now the span by effective depth ratio. Now we are going to discuss it later. I have to just put the value first here. Span by effective ratio for light beam is 50 to 20. For medium beam it is 12 to 15, and for heavy beam it is 10. There is no dimension of span by effective depth ratio. Okay, so what is span by effective depth ratio? At first you have to draw a beam. Now this is a beam and this is going to the support. This is support, both side. Okay. Now, span means here. Span means clear span. Not effective span. What is clear span? From face of the support, this is face of the support, and this this is face of the support. Distance between face of the supports is clear span. And what is effective span? Midpoint of support, from two midpoint of support is effective span. And what is depth, overall depth? This is the overall depth. And this is the cover. And this is the rod. And this is the effective depth. Now, effective depth is equal to overall depth minus cover minus 1 rod divided by 2. So this is span by effective depth ratio of 3 to 5 meters. Now span divided by effective span ratio, effective depth. Is equal to, let's say, 20 for span 3 meter or 3000 millimeter. Now span is 3000 millimeter by effective span is equal to 20. Effective span, effective depth, sorry, my mistake, it is effective depth. Effective depth is equal to 3000 by 20, that is 150 millimeter. Now, overall depth is equal to 150 plus, let's cover is 30 millimeter and one diameter of rod bar, one diameter of bar divided by 2, that's 16. So it will be 188, let's say 200 millimeter. Now this is the overall depth. This is the overall depth. Okay. So now you get it. This is how you can assume the depth of beam. If maybe light, medium or heavy, you can as you meet, or you can define it through the span by effective depth ratio. Okay. So thank you for watching my video.